feel out here.
And if that wasn't good, now that you see the fish I catch.
Yeah.
That'll put a smile on your face.
Creed's a very special place. It's got great people, the mines and the heritage.
In my never-ending pursuit to find the nicest RV resorts in the country, we struck gold today.
Hello everybody, I'm John Walker with Emerald Luxury Coaches. Thank you for stopping by today. We want to thank Andrew for the opportunity to sponsor today's video. We've been doing some really great videos with Andrew spotlighting our product, but today we want to show you one of the finest motor coach resorts in the country. We'd like to thank all the Emerald Luxury Coach owners and the associates and the team that make it possible for us to bring you the best value Prevost conversion on the market. Please check out some of our videos in the description down below and enjoy the tour of this beautiful resort today.
In the old mining town of Creed, Colorado, here at Mountain Views RV Resort. And this resort is absolutely stunning. Today I'm hanging out with the owner, Daryl. How you doing today, sir?
Doing great. How about you?
Excellent, thank you. So where are we hanging out at right now? What's going on, sir?
So we're hanging down on a lot of our river lots. This is one of our spectacular lots. We're very proud of what we've done here at Mountain Views. My daughter, Shay, and my son, Devin, and I run the resort, and we're very, very proud of the heritage that we have here. My father, Roland Zimmerman, and my mother, Helen Zimmerman, had a vision to create what you see here, and we're very proud of what Mountain Views represents.
Yeah, you've got an absolutely stunning resort here. Why don't we take the folks on YouTube on a tour of the resort? But first, you want to tell them a little bit about this lot?
This is one of our very special lots. This is actually a double lot. We've built the cabins. We've done the landscaping. We've partnered with a company here in Creed that does fabulous wrought iron work, as you see here. This is one of the lots that was purchased, or actually we do long-term leases. About a year and a half ago, we're totally vertical. We do the building, we do the landscaping, we do the maintenance, we own the real estate company. So when you come to Mountain Views and you want to have a special place, we work on creating that for you.
So you have ownership opportunities available as well as RV lot rentals available?
Correct. How our program works is it's a 40-year lease. It's willable, transferable, and saleable. You get all the benefits of ownership. But what we do is we're very particular about how the resort looks at the high level of excellence. So we have no HOAs here. So basically everything goes through myself and our family to create this atmosphere. HOAs are fine, but not here at Mountain Views in Colorado.
Well, I want to ask you some of the prices. I also want to learn a little bit about the history, future plans of the resort. Let's go show these folks around here.
This was our fourth and fifth phase. Obviously, it's along the river. We were just on that side. That's the new expansion for Mountain Views Motor Coach Estates. So what we do is, you know, I think I had mentioned to you before that we're the real estate company. We're the maintenance company. We're also the builder. So what we've done is a lot of our clients have bought one or two or three lots along the river to do special things. This side of the river, we can do up to 800 square foot cabins under roof. So what a lot of people have started to do is build their pavilions. We're in the middle now of just putting in final landscape and cleaning up. This lot right here, actually the gentleman that owns it bought this lot, and then the second lot became available, so he bought them both. He's going to be building a cabin on this lot right here, similar to what we're doing over here. This is probably the showpiece lot of Mountain Views. This is a spectacular double lot. There was really no expense spared on this lot. We did a pavilion, outdoor kitchen, and also right behind a toy garage that is pretty spectacular. Yeah, and in Colorado, you know, we're one of the very few resorts you can have the riverfront, an RV, and a cabin right on your property. We also have a very unique situation here is we're also a ride-out resort, which means that the ATVers, sport bikers, motocrossers, action sports, whatever it may be, has access to national forest right from our resort. You do not have to really trailer your ATVs or your side-by-sides out of the resort. You can ride right out into really hundreds of thousands, if not millions of acres of forestry land.
Nice.
We have a lot of very special guests here. We have Dean Laux, who is a very famous, world-renowned artist, doing some paintings up on the resort.
Looks like we caught Dean in action. Let's go see what he's up to up here.
Yeah.
Andrew Steele, what are you doing out here?
Hey, there he is. How you doing,
Dean? Good. How you doing?
Ya. Excellent. Looks like you're enjoying these Colorado mountains. What's all going
on
here?
Crazy. I mean, how can you not paint wonderful pictures with a view like this?
Pretty incredible here. What's what are you working on here? I don't know if we've seen this one yet.
Well, I put it on Facebook here a while back, but it's more of a black and white grayscale turtle, and I think this might start a whole new series. I'm really digging this.
Yeah, how are you enjoying Mountain Views RV Resort here in Creed, Colorado?
Well, just look out here. And if that wasn't good enough, you'd see the fish I catch.
Yeah.
That'll put a smile on your face. A lot of trout in here. I mean, the way I understand it, this few mile stretch of the Rio Grande has got the best fishing in Colorado.
What else have you been doing to stay busy up here?
Well, I think we got a golf trip on Thursday, so a little bit of golf, which I'm not, what I do to golf isn't really considered golf, but I try. So we got side by side, the Can-Am and the Razors. When we first got here, there was still snow up in the mountains. So we tried to go up over the pass with the snow, couldn't make it. So we went the opposite direction, came down the pass with the snow, and we made it that way. There's great mine tour out here, Last Chance Mine, look it up. And that is, that's an incredible place to go. The scenery out there and the way they built this mine on the side of the mountain is really neat. So a few good restaurants downtown and good hiking trails. So, geez, there's a lot to do. Depends what you want.
Looks like you've been doing some painting, though.
I've been doing some painting. Yeah, I try to wake up in the mornings, catch it early before it gets real hot. And then about this time, come back out because the sun, as you can see, is I'm now in the shade and I can continue to do what I enjoy.
Well, really exciting to see this new kind of style you've added to the Turtle Mode series. If someone wants to buy one of your Turtle Mode series paintings, how can they get a hold of you?
Go to deanlauxart.com or deanlauxart.com and or call the shop at 574-522-8838 and tell them you want to talk to me about a painting.
Awesome. Well, thanks again for everything, Dean. We'll see you around the resort.
All right. See you, buddy.
All right.
Everything on the left is the RV park, so that's daily, weekly, monthly. We've got about 97 sites over there. We've got a full laundry facility, bathhouse. We have two lodges, which I'll show you later. One is our bear lodge, one is our elk lodge. And then everything on the right-hand side is our RV resort, which is our ownership opportunities. So when you go to our website, you see both of these entities. They're all under one umbrella, which is Mountain Views at River's Edge. But what we do is we try to cater to everybody. We don't want anyone to be really left out. So there's special restrictions on the resort side, which is 28 feet or longer, fifth wheel or motor coach only, no bumper pulls. But in the park, you know, we basically allow anything. So if we make a left, like we're doing now, we have our main office, which is right here. My daughter Shay runs that office. We have a lot of green space throughout the park and the resort.
Yeah, now how many total sites are there in the resort side versus the park side?
Yeah, there's, right now I think there's a little over 300 in the resort. And then in the park over here we have 97.
Okay, and what are the typical rates? I know there's a range of rates that probably varies seasonally. Are you open year-round or are you seasonal?
Seasonal on this side of the park. And in the resort, but our new expansion, we're gonna be going across the river, which I just finished building our bridge across the Rio Grande. That's gonna be open a lot more months than what we are right now. This side of the resort and park is May 1 through September 30th. But what we're gonna try to do across the river, since we're putting in brand new infrastructure over there, is we're gonna try to capture, you know, a few months on both sides of May and on the end of September. At some point in time, this is gonna transform from the daily, weekly, monthly RV park to resort. So these will all be sold as ownership opportunities. But what we want to do is that most of the people in this side of the RV park have been with us for 20 years. And I want to make sure that we cover them forever and always for as long as they want to be here. So before we do a transition to start converting the park to the resort, I want to make sure that we have another new RV park, which is right across the street. It's going to be 150 units approximately, and everyone that has been with us and helped us develop the resort and the park the way that we have, we want to be loyal to them. So we're going to allow them to either keep their lots here for as long as they want, they won't be sold, or they can transition over to the new RV park.
Okay.
So we want to stay loyal to our customer base.
And how long has the RV park been here?
I think we're going on our 18th or 19th year.
Wow, and how long have you been the owner of this park?
So, what we did is, when we first purchased this, it was my dad, we had two partners, great partners, and myself. And so my dad was the visionary behind a lot of what you see here. I was in the apparel industry for many, many years with him. And he retired, came to Colorado, and his retirement lasted about 15 minutes. And he called me up and said, send me some money. We're gonna build RV resorts in Colorado. So, turn this off.
Yeah, now, what caused you to choose Creed and choose this area? It's kind of off the beaten path. How did you find this location?
Yeah, we when my dad came to Colorado, we were looking for places in Pagosa. We were looking at places in Glenwood Springs, you know, all through the state when I was younger. And we just happened to come upon this little mining town called Creed, which is basically right there.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just that Creed's a very special place. It's got great people, the mines and the heritage and everything for the town of Creed when we actually got here. It's a captivating place. And we decided that when we built Mountain Views, you know, it really wasn't about building an RV park resort. It was about creating a community with another community, which is Creed, and coming together to develop. You know, I think you and your team have seen that we, you know, we have a special vibe here, and it just all came together. So it was basically by accident. We just came across it, and this was a very old RV park. There wasn't one tree or any utilities on the property that we just drove around. My father and, you know, our team created, you know, all of this.
Yeah.
So it's been a fun journey.
Yeah. Now, looks like there's a dog park back there. You've got two dog parks, and then there's a lot of buildings I see out here. What are some of these really large buildings that we see?
Yeah, so that's a dog park. The big building right here that we're going to go by, that's our Elk Lodge. And it holds a little over 300 people. The heritage of Creed is really in there. We've captured that. The facility is great. Gourmet kitchens, big open space for parties or events. We allow all of our guests to use it. You can rent it out at no charge. We just ask that you put it back the way that you found it. Over here on the right-hand side is our Bear Lodge.
Yeah.
What that is that we do, in the mornings, we do coffee and refreshments and kind of danishes and cinnamon rolls and a coffee bar. And then throughout the day, it kind of opens and closes depending on how many people are in the resort. But it's a really nice little area. You know, kids like to go in there and play pool or play cards or games and things like that.
Nice.
This is the resort. This was our first phase that was started 17, 18 years ago. But you want to talk about past, present, and future.
Yes, sir.
Here's your future is right here. This is Mountain View's Motor Coach Estates.
Okay.
We literally just finished this bridge about 2 weeks ago. And what it is that this is the passage across the Rio Grande River. And what we're going to have over here is 87 ownership opportunity lots. We've got 20 along the river. We did our first phase of sales in the first 5 days that we offered in May. We sold 10 river lots.
Wow.
You can see the size.
So are there any river lots still available?
Yeah, we've got 10 river lots available. We're going to reopen opportunities probably the 1st of August. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to start to get the infrastructure in. So as you can see, we've got the dirt roads right now. There's about 67 internal lots. They're priced anywhere from $275,000 to $400,000. What's nice about over here is that we're approved for 1,375 square foot cabins. And the other resort, right off your right shoulder over there, those are approved for 800 square foot under roof. So we're twice as big over here in the resort. Also back along that hill right there, there's 10 lots that we can build up to 1,675 square foot.
Nice.
So one of the important things that I try to communicate is that, you know, for us to be a five-star resort, we have to make sure that we build our infrastructure to do that. And this is a good view of what was the past and where we're going in the future, is that in the beginning, we were allowed canvas structures, and you can see those right along the river right now. When those structures start to look a little shabby, so to speak,
yes, sir,
those all have to be converted to either pavilions and or cabins. So that was the past. And then I'll show you the vision for the future. We want to create the vibe of what was the past and the heritage of the company, but where it's going, and where it's going is what you see right here along the river, with the cabins and coach retreats. That's the future of what we're going to do throughout the whole entire resort. So when you come to Mountain Views, you know, that's what you can expect, that level of excellence. Like I was telling you before, we own the maintenance company, we own the real estate company, we own the building company. We're totally vertical. So when you come in and you select a piece of property here, you sit down with each one of our teams, and what we ask is we just want to know what your end goal is. And then what we do is we custom design, you know, whatever you want into the model that you request. And, you know, we give you kind of like your dream here in Colorado. I have some special exclusive lots that I still own on the river that are my owner lots that are up in the $550,000 to $600,000 range, but they're very exclusive. But you can see the views from this side of the river.
Yeah.
Are amazing. 360 degree views.
I don't think there's a bad view anywhere on this property.
It's pretty amazing. And when we, you know, when we built that bridge, we spent a little bit extra time for navigation of the river. We have the gabion baskets, which allow the river to flow through those baskets. It doesn't create a backflow type situation as you might see in other bridges where the concrete goes into the river, the water hits those concrete barriers, and they cause like a backflow turbulence that when the rafters go down, they could hit that and flip over. What we've done is we've created a pass-through system that has no backflow or anything like that. So we took special interest in making sure that we looked at all the safety precautions when we were putting in that bridge.
Cool. But Daryl, I can't thank you enough for showing me and the folks on YouTube around your incredible resort here. If someone is a serious buyer and they're looking to purchase one of these beautiful lots here, or just come and rent an RV site, who should they get a hold of? And
they can call the office, or they can call me at 908-894-3660. That's my direct line. We'd be happy to have any questions that we can answer, and we enjoy having good people come here to Mountain Views.
Awesome. Anything else you want to share with the folks on YouTube?
I just appreciate you coming out, and it was nice seeing you and nice having you here, and we love what you're doing, and we really appreciate the support you give to the RV community.
Awesome. Can't thank you enough. I also greatly appreciate all of you out there on YouTube subscribing to the channel and liking these videos. I hope you're all having a great day. Thanks again.